Hello students, today we have to start the next continuation part in the lesson Indian Forest Resources. Till yesterday we have to get to know that the types of forest and all. Okay, today what are the we have to know about the distribution of forest, actually how the forest area has distributed in India. Okay, forest in India is not evenly distributed, evenly in the sense not equally distributed to all the region. 60% of the forest in the Himalaya, keep in mind, the 60% of the forest, it is in, where it is in Himalayan mountain only. Himalayan mountain, 60% of the Indian forest, it is in the Himalayan mountain. And the next 20% of the forest is in the Northern Plain. The remaining 20% is in the Northern Plain. Northern Plain. And the remaining remaining percentage in the sense, remaining 20%, it is in Madhya Pradesh. Okay, it is in where? Madhya Pradesh, keep in mind. Okay, so that's why in our regions, except the mountain region and everything, in a land area, the Madhya Pradesh as the largest forest area. Keep in mind, Madhya Pradesh, MP. MP means not member of parliament, it is Madhya Pradesh. Madhya Pradesh as the largest forest area in the land, and also Goa as the lowest forest area. Okay, Goa has the lowest forest area, but Madhya Pradesh as the largest forest area in our India. So this is about the distribution of forest in the India. Next, you know about that nowadays the forest destruction more is happened. What are the reasons for the destruction of forest, or the forest destruction, Kadina Nasha, forest destruction? So let us know what are the reasons for the forest destruction. The first one is expansion of agricultural land, because many of the farmers are cut the forest area, forest and everything, that area has made them to agriculture. Okay, so that is expansion of agricultural land. Next, a construction of road, railway. For the construction of roads, railway purpose, the forest area has getting damaged. Okay, construction of roads, railway. Next one is the construction of dams, like irrigation project, for that construction of dams. Okay, many of them, they are cut at the forest area and construct the dams. For that 1000 acres, 2000 acres of the forest will be destructed in the sense, destroyed. Then due to the industrialization, so many of the people started cut the forest and started their industries. Okay, and made the city into industrialized city, that is called industrialization. Industrialization in the sense, establishment of industries. Okay, and also urbanization. What is mean by urbanization? Cutting the forest or the wood in the forest and make the area into urbans, urban in the sense cities. Okay, making city is called as the urbanization, establishment of industries is called the industrialization. Keep in mind, what is mean by industrialization? Establishment of more industries is called the industrialization, and making the area into city, urban in the sense city, that is called as a urbanization. As these were the reasons for the forest destruction, along with overgrazing is also there, and forest fire. Overgrazing in the sense, many of the cattle are grazed, okay, completely the graze everything, that is the overgrazing. And forest fire also one of the reason for the forest fire. Okay, forest destruction, these are the reason for the forest destruction, which are those: expansion of agriculture, construction of roads, railways, etc., construction of dams, industrialization, urbanization, overgrazing, and forest fire. So what is mean by conservation of the forest? The prevention of destruction and protecting the forest is called as the conservation of forest. Conservation means protection, rakshane madodu, that is called as the conservation of forest. Okay, so preventing the destruction of forest and conserving, I mean protecting, okay, that is called as the conservation of forest. So measures, what are the measures to conserve the forest? What are the ideas? Measures in the sense ideas. Okay, what are the ideas to conserve the forest? One is called the control the deforestation. You want to control the deforestation. Deforestation means, I told you already, cutting of trees. Okay, so we want to control the cutting of trees and encourage for afforestation and reforestation. Afforestation means growing trees, and reforestation means protecting the trees what are already is there. That is called reforestation. Okay, protecting the trees what are the trees already is there is called as the reforestation. Afforestation means growing the new trees. Deforestation means cutting down of the tree. Okay, so control the deforestation, encouragement has given for the afforestation and the reforestation. Next, control the forest fire. We want to control the forest fire. Control forest fire. Control forest fire. So these are the measures to control the conservation of forest, and also the controlling the illegal cutting of the trees. Many of the peoples are cut the illegal trees illegally in a forest without any permission. So control the illegal cutting of the trees and control the forest insects and the diseases, because many of the trees are fall off due to the diseases and due to the infection. We want to now and then the government has to spray the insecticide or pesticide to the forest, so that will avoid the diseases. Actually, then the creating awareness in the minds of the people. Creating the awareness in the minds of the people. Next, scientific cutting of a tree. Scientific cutting of a tree in the sense unknown way. Many of the people cut the tree unknown way. If they are cutting a tree unknown way, they will not regrow. Okay, so if the trees are cut scientifically, may the trees will regrow. Okay, so that is scientific cutting of a tree. Scientific cutting of a tree in the sense make the trees to regrow after a cutting also, that is called as the scientific cutting of a tree. So these are all the measures we can take to conserve the forest. Yes, many wildlife sanctuaries are there in India. So which are the wildlife sanctuaries? What is mean by wildlife sanctuaries? The forest area where the wildlife are protected, that area is called as the wildlife sanctuaries. I think you know about that. Nowadays forest is also destructed as well as the wildlife is also destructed. Is it? So to protect the wildlife in the sense the animals which are living in a forest, they are called as a wildlife. I think you know about that. So what is mean by wildlife sanctuaries? The area in which forest area the wildlife are protected, that area is called as the wildlife sanctuaries. Which are the example for wildlife sanctuaries of India? That is Annamalai and Madhumalai in Tamil Nadu. Very important. Annamalai and Madhumalai. Where it is? Annamalai and Madhumalai. It is in Tamil Nadu. Okay, Malay means forest area. Okay, it is a Tamil word actually. Malay means forest area. Annamalai and Madhumalai in Tamil Nadu. Then Dandeli, Bhadra, Talakaveri, BR Hills in Karnataka. Karnataka wildlife sanctuaries are Dandeli, Bhadra forest area nearby to Hampi. Then Talakaveri you know already, and Bihar Hills. Bihar means Biligiri Rangana Hills. So where the ducks are protected. Okay, Bihar Hills. Where it is? They are in Karnataka. Karnataka means K. Okay, these are the wildlife sanctuaries of Karnataka. Then Kerala wildlife sanctuary, that is Periyar. Periyar means, I told you already, that is a senior citizen. Okay, so that name has given actually. So that is in, where it is? Periyar wildlife sanctuary, that is in Kerala. Okay, it is in Kerala. Then Nagarjuna Sagara in Telangana, new state. Nagarjuna Sagara It is in Telangana. Telangana and Simandhra are the new states of Andhra Pradesh. Okay. Nagarjuna Sagara in Telangana. Then Bharatpura and Ranathambore in Rajasthan. Bharatpur and Ranathambore in Rajasthan. Then Manasa in Assam. Manas in Assam. Next is Joldhapura in West Bengal. Joldhapura in West Bengal. So these were the wildlife sanctuaries of India. Here the wild animals are protected. Keep in mind where it is. Annamalai and Madhumalai in Tamil Nadu. Dandeli, Bhadra, Talakaveri, BR Hills in Karnataka. BR Hills nothing but the Biligiri Rangana Hills. Okay. BR Hills shortly known as BR. Okay. Biligiri Rangana shortly known as BR Hills. Then Periyar in Kerala. Nagarjuna Sagara in Telangana. Bharatpura, Ranathambore in Rajasthan, Manas in Assam, and Joldhapura, however we can read. Okay, so that is Joldhapura in West Bengal. So these were the wildlife sanctuary. Sanctuary in the sense the area where the wildlife are protected. Okay, so these are the important wildlife sanctuaries of India. Tomorrow we have to know about the some biosphere reservoirs and the national parks. So till that you have to keep watching. Thank you all.